how Conor McGregor spends his millions. If we're talking polarizing figures in the world of sport and in the general landscape of entertainment, then nobody fits the bill more than Conor McGregor. The Irishman has had a meteoric rise to the top of mixed martial arts in the last few years, and in many ways, the recent success of the Ultimate Fighting Championship has all been down to him, and he's the perfect antithesis to austerity spending. The man loves to splurge on whim, and materialism is definitely the order of the day for him. Currently ranked 24 on the Forbes list of the world's highest paid athletes, Conor McGregor has come a long way from being a working class plumber to embracing success and wealth, courtesy of his exploits in the octagon. Before all of that though, it's time to take a closer look at the Irishman. So here's the list how Conor McGregor spends his millions. Got you rolling, and here I am, Majestics. Don't forget to smash that like button, and don't forget to hit subscribe and ring that notification bell. And then be sure to check always instead of sometimes to get fresh and updated amusing videos in the YouTube world. Anyone with the buying power and lavish taste as grandiose as Conor McGregor's would imperatively invest more in fancy cars. Conor's love for slick-looking, mean machines is evident, as his impressive array boasts of some of the most high-end names in the business. His mighty fleet of cars includes a Lamborghini Huracan Avio, probably one of his most prized possessions, draped in Irish green. This limited edition version was produced by Lamborghini in a typically Air Force reminiscent style, dotted with sophisticated custom touches that reinforce why this brand is typically hailed by the rich and famous. The funniest part of his purchase is that he hasn't even been seen driving this. McGregor also loves his Rolls-Royce Phantom drophead coupe, standing at a whopping $500,000. His other vehicular acquisitions also include a BMW i8, a Rolls-Royce Ghost, a Lamborghini Aventador Roadster, a Cadillac Escalade, a Chevrolet Corvette Stingray, and a BMW 730 Sport. Perhaps more. Loads more. How about investing a fortune to a fur coat? In the wake of activist movements, fewer and fewer celebrities wear real fur. And then there's Conor McGregor, who doesn't seem to care. In a press conference leading to the UFC 205, in which McGregor faced Eddie Alvarez, the notorious Irishman showed up in a pearly white Gucci mink coat. His bold fashion statement seemed rather bizarre, but who is McGregor to care? Boxing fans took a cue from this and associated it with a publicity stunt akin to Joe Frazier's. McGregor, with this stunt of his, did leave fans and media quizzing with regards to the price he paid for this coat. Those with an eye for detail, especially the paparazzi who paid attention, were able to spot the price tag still hanging to the coat. Makes me wonder whether leaving the price tag hanging was a deliberate move on Conor McGregor's part. Maybe not, maybe yes. Amongst other valuable possessions of McGregor's is his collection of watches, and that is his $20 million watch. Known for accessorizing himself with some of the costliest watches in the market, as opposed to wearing bling, McGregor is a huge fan of Rolex watches, and his arsenal of horology boasts of pricey models such as the Rolex Oyster Perpetual Cosmograph Daytona. He likes to showcase his watches on Instagram. He's actually showcasing everything he buys, and during his press conferences. Except for when he's fighting, Conor is always seen sporting high-end watches and is also known for gifting them to his dear ones. The sportsman hailing from the elite bracket, who is revered equally for his sharpness as for his attacking gameplay, may very well be on his way to having a custom Rolex watch designed for himself. Don't try and tell me that the gold belt sitting up right there will not look great with this ivory elephant trunk suit that I have on me right now. The man loves to dress sharply and is known for having an extensive collection of suits. He also never wears the same outfit again. Almost all of his suits are custom designed and can't be found in regular stores, much to the dismay of those wanting to dress up like McGregor. In stark contrast to his persona inside the octagon, McGregor takes pride in his dressing sense, and why wouldn't he? After all, the working class man has worked his way up the ranks. Each of his suits fall in the $4,000 to $10,000 US dollar range. And if you do the math, you realize how much this man values his style quotient. Leading up to the bout against Floyd Mayweather, McGregor raised eyeballs sporting his fuck you suit. The replica of that suit itself costs about $6,000. Yes, the replica. Let's cheers to that. We're confident in saying that you don't even need to like whiskey to appreciate what Conor McGregor has done with his proper 12 brand. After spending a few years developing it, his dream finally became a reality. Conor McGregor chose an opportune moment to announce his plans to launch an Irish whiskey brand. It was the night of June 14, 2017. The Irish mixed martial arts MMA fighter had it took another year before McGregor's whiskey hit the market, debuting in Ireland and the US in September 2018. Rather than carrying his notorious nickname, as McGregor suggested, the brand instead launched a proper number 12. Less than 2 years on, only the cocksure Irishman could have predicted its success. In July 2020, reports emerged that Jose Cuervo had exercised stock options to increase its share in the brand from 20 to 49%. Based on the amount paid for shares, the sale valued the Irish whiskey brand at 200 million euros, roughly 235 million US dollars at the time of publishing. Also, it'll also feature on the canvas during his bout with the undefeated Russian Khabib, which can only be a good thing. Some reviews have suggested that there's nothing all too special about the whiskey itself, but let's be honest with ourselves, it's still going to sell well and come flying off the shelves. What's up? Let's roll in and scratch. And so what are your thoughts on how Conor McGregor spends his millions? You're just in the middle of the video, Majestics, and you'll be bemused to learn what's on the bottom of our list today. So make sure you stay until the end of the list. And by the way, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and to turn those notifications on. Not just a fighter, he's also a self-made businessman. Conor always dreamed of having his own business of sorts, and in the lead-up to the Floyd Mayweather fight last year, it was confirmed that he'd achieved his goal in the form of McGregor Sports and Entertainment. You could tell that he was just as excited by that as he was the actual fight, and can you blame him? Having your own entertainment brand is a big statement in itself, and we'll likely see it being plastered all over the marketing for his upcoming fight against Khabib at UFC 229. From his Las Vegas mansion to his home just outside of Dublin, Conor McGregor likes to live it up wherever he goes, especially when it comes to where he lays his head at night. From the security system to the comfort to the overall size, is it any wonder that the guy wants to make sure everything is perfect in this regard? He moves at a million miles an hour more often than not, so when he has a chance to do his own thing in the privacy of his own home, you'd best believe that he's going to make it extravagant in its own right. Conor does also seem to enjoy the downtime of traveling around the world. It feels like he really enjoys himself most when he's chilling out with his family and friends, while not going too crazy in the process. From New York to Ibiza, Conor certainly knows how to make the most of his time off, and we can't exactly blame him for that. He has enough money to spend the next 20 years traveling, and while he isn't doing it all the time, it's definitely a possibility in the future. Fancy inviting us around to watch the fight sometime, pal? A training camp that has a six figures. Any and all training camps are pretty expensive, from the equipment to paying your trainers to paying the guys or girls that you're bringing in to spar with. It's an intricate process, and it needs to be handled with care. Conor has been open about the fact that he spent six figures for his training camps in order to really get the most out of his experience, and it's good to hear that he's so committed to it. The man still loves the mixed martial arts game with a deep passion, and that'll be the case until the day he dies. Partying is something that Conor could and probably should tone down on. The guy obviously has every right to enjoy himself given that he made a nine-figure sum against Mayweather, but it seems as if he might have taken things too far once or twice. We can't know that for sure, but some of his actions have been downright baffling. And regardless of whether or not he defeats Nurmagomedov, it'll be fascinating to see how he reacts in the immediate aftermath. Will he dive straight back into another fight camp, or will he go on another three-day bender? Conor is also a good Samaritan. Simon Community and Inner City Helping Homeless are two of the more notable charities that Conor McGregor has helped out over the years, as the Irishman attempts to give back to the community that helped to raise him and mold him into the man you see before you today. The guy has had a few controversies over the years, but there's absolutely no denying that his heart is in the right place, 99 times out of 100. And this is an example of that. He could easily go his entire life without donating a single penny to these charities, but he does care, and that's vitally important to remember. Surely secured and protected. From rumours of a mob wanting to go after him to his general haters watching his every move, there's cause for concern when it comes to Conor McGregor's overall safety. The guy often doesn't do himself many favours, but at the end of the day, he's probably going to be just fine. Why? Well, one of the reasons why he's probably because of the huge bodyguards he employs. McGregor knows that he can't have eyes in the back of his head, and he ensures that he remains as safe as he possibly can be whenever he steps out into the public eye. A generous and lavish son. Conor McGregor's parents helped to shape him into the man that he is today. And whether you agree with his methods or not, it seems as if they've done a pretty good job when you lay it all out. As such, Conor's been able to pay his mother and father back for all that they've done for him over the years. From buying them nice things to paying off their mortgage. He knows where his loyalties lie, and that's great to see. We noted earlier on in the video that he's a family man, and he's always lived up to that. And the stories that he's told from his childhood are already legendary. Very stylish Irishman. Conor, from custom shoes for fights to general attire, he always makes sure that he looks the part from head to toe. And that includes his footwear. No ensemble is complete without a strong pair of shoes, and a man as in touch with fashion as McGregor knows that. We know that it sounds like we're just obsessed with the guy at this point, but you can't deny the facts. He knows how to style and profile. Sure, he gets a little bit too cocky with it sometimes, and it can be deemed over the top, but his shoe game is almost always right on the money. Styling and profiling. Conor McGregor announced last year that he'd be teaming up with David August in order to create a whole new line of suits, as he continues to begin other ventures outside of professional fighting, which in the long run is probably the smart move. This particular idea is probably slightly less accessible to the general public than the whiskey, but at the same time, it's something that he appears to be deeply passionate about. We're still waiting to hear more about the whole thing, but given that it took a year to uncover more about Proper 12, we imagine an announcement could be imminent. Frustratedly wants to defeat the pretty boy. Speaking of boxing, Conor spent an awful lot of money on ensuring that he could defeat Floyd Mayweather in 2017. While he wasn't able to pull it off, he certainly did everything in his power to make it happen, and his boxing preparations likely set him back quite a bit. We wouldn't even be surprised to learn that he's still doing separate boxing training alongside MMA. Because there are rumblings that he wants to return to the ring in order to get a W on his record. We can't say that we blame him, because he's certainly got some potential. We had to come to another negative sooner rather than later, and here we are, the infamous bus incident. For those of you who don't know, Conor threw a dolly through a bus window in an attempt to get to Khabib Nurmagomedov, who he faces in Las Vegas on October the 6th. The entire issue occurred as a result of an incident between Conor's friend Artem Lobov and Khabib, with McGregor wanting to defend the honour of his pal. Alas, it landed him in some seriously hot water, and he had to pay some significant fees in order to get out of it. He's not just a generous son, he's also a generous husband. Based on assumptions alone, Dee Devlin has had to put up with a lot of stuff over the years. McGregor can't be an easy person to deal with on a day-to-day basis at the best of times, and we can only imagine her reactions to some of the controversies he's been involved in. Still, they seem to be happy together, and you can bet that Conor will treat Dee to whatever she desires, because let's face it, she more than deserves it, and we sincerely hope that they have a long and happy life together, because it'd be nice for both of them to have a fairy tale ending with their children. What can you say about how Conor McGregor spends his millions? Let us know in the comments section below so that we know that you're still alive, eating, inspiring, and kicking. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a big thumbs up and subscribe to our channel so we can give you more and enlighten your curiosity and continue to give the best, brightest, and finest content. Hey, thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video. Toodles.